I'm sitting beside my camper, high up in the Catalina Mountains, when a medieval knight walks by. Just around the corner, I find six knights in full armor, and they're getting ready to fight. This is not scripted, and those long swords and axes are very real, though mercifully blunt. Their armor weighs 70 pounds, and we're at 8,300 feet, so the match lasts only 40 seconds.
Stop fight!
Then they have a rest, get up, and go at it again. They're a friendly bunch, with dogs and children playing on the sidelines. Spouses help with the armor and bring the combatants drinks. They call themselves the Hellhounds, and Matthew was one of their first members.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready.
Fight!
It's full speed, full power, full force. You are trying to take your opponent down to the ground. So you want to hit him in a soft spot, like a hip, which is generally not all that well protected. An armpit is great. Once he's on the ground, he is out of combat. He cannot get back up until that round is over. It's always good to, you know, twitch a little bit so that the referees and everybody know that you're okay.
Their armor is authentic. They could pass for knights on any medieval battlefield in Europe or the Middle East. Almost. It's not just heavy. It's extremely complicated.
Oh, that's what we used.
What are you taking, your axe?
He's going now.
And you need an awful lot of it. A full set of gear will run you almost $3,000. And with all the fighting, it doesn't last that long. It's not easy on the human body either.
This is, in essence, a blood sport.
Injuries are common.
The way most of us look at the injuries, it's what we pay to play.
And that can be very hard on spouses.
Some of them start buying armor and come out to the field and start fighting. My wife understands why I do this and doesn't really like to watch it when I'm on the field.
Many come out to help their partners, even if it's just to be there in case things go wrong. So what sort of person becomes an armored combat fighter?
Maybe a little type A personality. They're also going to want to have a good sense of humor. And they must really love adrenaline.
They welcome anyone who wants to try it.
That's it.
We have women fighters.
Arms, legs, they all count.
Okay.
Some youth fighters, you can't fight until you're 18, but we do some training with them.
After half a dozen rounds, they're pretty much wiped out.
Done. Lights out. Stop fight.
They eat donut holes while peeling off their sweaty armor and repairing broken gear.
I'm all set.
in the end, you get the feeling that it's more about camaraderie than combat, and that they really care about each other, on and off the field.